Hello guys, welcome back to our YouTube channel. In this tutorial, I'm going to discuss how we create the runner file in a Cucumber framework. Okay, so currently you can see I am running the feature files by right clicking on the particular feature files and then running the scenario. Okay, but we can execute this scenario by using the runner file where we can call the multiple feature files and then we can run that. This is just like a suit XML file which we are creating in a test engine. Okay, so here we can create the runner file. I'm going to create runner file by using the JUnit notation. So this is the JUnit runner file. Okay, so let me create a class name. Let me create one package so that I can separate the runner file, like com.runner. JUnit runner. Okay. So this is just a empty file. Okay, JUnit runner is empty file where we need to apply some annotations of Cucumber annotation. Okay, and then we can pass some values. Okay, so how we do that? Let me explain. Okay, we need to call here @runbit. Okay, and here we need to pass cucumber.class. Okay, and then next we need to pass cucumber option. And this cucumber options, okay, where we will pass the details here. Okay, and here we need to import the JUnit Cucumber option, JUnit Cucumber runner. Okay, and here first of all we need to pass the feature file. Okay, means where is our feature file, and then I will give the feature file reference. Okay, so this is src test resources/features. Okay, so first of all I need to pass the feature files location by using the feature keyword. Okay, and next we need to pass the glue. Basically in glue we need to mention where is our step definition file. Okay, so step definition is under the com.steps. Okay, so I need to give the name here, package name of the step definition. We can also use here the plugin that will create a reporting. Okay, so one is I am going to use the pretty. Okay, this will generate the report on a console, and we can also use the and generate the Cucumber HTML report as well as the JSON report. Okay, so we need to call here Cucumber plugin HTML, and I am going to create this under the target folder. I will give the folder name, and this is the folder name. So HTML report will generate under this target Cucumber report. Okay, next we can also add the one other plugins, JSON plugin that will generate the report in a JSON format. Okay, so JSON target. Report name. So I will pass here the report.json. Okay, so one JSON file generated by using this file name like target report.json file. Okay, these options we can pass here in order to execute the test Okay, and now I'm going to run. So you can see I have mentioned here the feature file, so features folder. So this will automatically run all the features which are available under this section, this folder. We can mention any particular file here, okay, that will execute one file. Now I'm going to run and you will see jcpenry file will execute only. Okay, so now this is running test one by one. Okay, so executed all test, and here we will get the report into the target folder. Let me refresh. You can see target folder is generated here. One is the Cucumber report, okay, and this is the JSON file. Okay, so JSON file is generated like this, and all the steps and everything we will get here, and this will very helpful to publish the reports on the Jenkins environment. When we are running the Jenkins, so we can use this JSON to publish the report there. Okay. So next. Okay, so one more thing. I need to pass here the .html extension to generate the report into HTML format. As of now, you can see this is not generated the proper HTML report, right? So we can give the .html. Okay, so that will execute the report into HTML format. Okay, we can open this on browser. Okay, let me check this on here. Okay, so let me open this directly. Yeah, this is target, and here you can see the execution report. So this will generate the reports, default report by the Cucumber. Okay, here you can see feature, title of this, background scenario, and this. So this detail you can see is generated here, one scenario. Okay, so now next, what we can do, we can also pass here the only feature folder name. So this will run all the feature files which are available under this folder. Okay, so now I am going to run and you will see the result, like all the feature files will execute. So there are one feature files contains these number of scenarios, and next login functionality, this will be login into the Orange CRM application. Okay, so all the tests will execute one by one from the this runner file. Now this is going to run the Orange CRM application. Okay, so all the tests is executed, and now if I open this report, and you will see here both scenario. Okay, yeah, both scenarios executed like this scenario test, and here you will get the scenario run successfully. Okay, so we can use the runner file also to generate the report into HTML format as well as the XML format. Okay, and now next, how we run the test cases by using the tag. Okay, what is the tag? So we can add the some tags over the scenario as well as the feature file. Okay, like if I add here one tag on the feature file Orange CRM. Okay, so this tag will be very useful to identify the test cases, to mark the test cases, like for the regression, for the smoke testing, for the any modules wise we can mention, and then we can run the test by passing this tag in runner file. Okay, now in next we can pass the tag name. Okay, next step we can pass the tag name to execute the test. Tag equal to, I need to pass double quotes and then @ and tag name. Okay, so here I have mentioned the tag orange HRM. So this will execute the scenario on only the orange HRM. So this will execute the tags where I have mentioned the orange HRM. Okay, so now I'm going to run at this, and in that case you will see only one scenario will execute, okay, with the tag name orange HRM. Okay, now it's run. Similar type, we can add the tags on a scenario as well as on a particular feature file as well as on scenario. Like I'm going to add here one scenario, like suppose that smoke, okay, and this is for the regression. I am going to use a regression. Okay, we can also include multiple tags, like here I am using a regression as well as I am going to use here a regression. So if I call the regression, so all the scenarios will execute where I have added the regression, and if we are using the smoke, so all the scenarios will execute where I have added the smoke. So one scenario or one feature file, we can add more than one tags. Okay, like here I have added the regression as well as the smoke. Now I am going to run this test by using the smoke tag. Okay, so let's see what will happen. So in that case, two scenario will execute. Okay, one from the JCPenney, and second is the from the orange HRM. Okay, so two scenario is executed, and you can see both scenario, this one and second is this one. Okay, so now I am going to use the regression tag. So when I use the regression tag, so this scenario will execute as well as that this. It means there are four times this will execute. Okay, let me add the this tag, regression tag. So tag will play very important roles when we are going to run a particular group of test cases, group of scenarios in of a cucumber. Okay, we can use corresponding tag and execute the test. Okay, so now this is running last test orange from orange HRM. Okay, thanks. Thanks for watching the video, and hope this will help to understand the concept of the runner file. Okay, and if you have any doubts, any query, you can leave comment. I will definitely reply on that. Thanks for watching the video.